What's up, everybody? It's Christy Bentleff, and you are tuning in to another segment of Motoring Motivations. That's right. It's just me, my Mini Cooper, some awesome dance music in the background, and sharing a quote or two or life experiences that I hope will motivate you in some small way to make change in your life today. So I wanted to start this one off with something that I read recently, and it says, everyone wants to be successful until they see or hear what it actually takes. And that is so profound. I'll read it again to you. Everyone wants to be successful until they see what it actually takes. You know what? Successful people, when they're passionate about something, whether it's starting a business or they're a motivational coach or they're a manager of a business or they're an owner of a business, they are in it. They are passionate about what they're doing, and you know what? They will do whatever it takes. And let me tell you, when you are successful, you give up a lot because you're trying to make your business successful or your venture successful, and it requires a lot of time on your part. Time researching, time working it, time, you know, getting out there, you know, getting the product moving, whatever the case may be. It is a lot of time. For an example, a lot of people want to be a consultant. They want to get out and they want to help people, but then they see the flip side of it. It requires a lot of travel. It requires a lot of phone calls and contacts, you know, ongoing with your clients. It is not an 8-to-5 job. It requires a lot of discipline. You're having to work at home. You're having to be on the go. You know, a lot of moving parts, and that's the way it is in any business. I was very fortunate enough that I got to, you know, my brother-in-law has a great, you know, restaurant, and he's managed a lot of businesses up in Maine, and he is just successful in everything he does. And I thought, wow, it just seems so effortless for him. You know, we kind of wanted to take a look at that. You know what? You know, as much as I was excited to see what he did after like about a month or two, I was like, that's not the lifestyle for me, because again, it required 24/7 dedication, and it wasn't something that I shared that passion for, so it didn't work for me. So, you know, however, on the flip side, doing something like I'm doing now, or life coaching people, or getting out and talking about things like this, you know, I could spend hours upon hours doing it, and you know, it's sort of like my hobby. But you know, that's the difference with successful people and people that, you know, don't want to put the work in. So again, everyone wants to be successful until they see what it actually takes. Let me tell you, in order to be successful, it takes a lot. It's quite draining on some days, and other days it is 100% plus fulfilling. But you know what? I get out there and I do it 24/7 every single day because it's something that I love to do. Now, when it becomes a point that it wastes my time, then, you know, I have to ask questions to myself, is it time to move on to a different venture? So just keep in mind, you know, when you look at somebody that's very successful and you're like, you know, I can do that, you know, why don't you stop, you know, if that's something you really want to do, why don't you take them out to lunch and, you know, talk to them a little bit and get to know a little bit about what goes on in their day-to-day routine, because it, you know, successful people, let me tell you, it is not an 8-to-5 venture. It is 24/7 a lot of times, and they sacrifice, you know, family and relationships to get to that success level, and that's sometimes what, you know, stops other people from doing it. But you know, like I said, you know, nothing ventured, nothing gained. You know, if you want to be successful, you've got to put the work in. So until next time, guys, take care and have an awesome start to your week.